What's going on, guys? It is Zach with the Firefly Remedy, and welcome back to another video. Today, I'm gonna kind of be doing some commentary-esque stuff. I just want to talk about some things completely surrounding Black Ops Cold War and give you an outside perspective on it because I play on Xbox, and obviously, because I play on Xbox, I don't get any of the exclusive rights to play the game early, which is a bunch of shit. As you can see here, got a nice little haircut. First haircut in like a year, by the way, guys. And we're just gonna be hopping into some Black Ops 1 games here. Because what I've heard, and one of the big things that really excites me about the game from what I've heard, is that it plays similar to the older games. And a lot of people think of that as a bad thing. I don't really think of that as a bad thing. A lot of people have said it reminds them of World at War, which is my favorite COD game of all time, mind you, and Black Ops 1. I also heard that the sniping is quite a lot like Modern Warfare 2. From what I've seen, the sniping is very OP, and they're gonna have to tone it down a little bit. But once again, I haven't played the game. I'm just giving you my thoughts and criticisms based on what I've seen. I've watched a lot of streams and videos. Before we get into the video, I just wanna remind you guys to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. I'm gonna be posting so much COD content over the next few months, and hopefully years to come, especially because I'm really excited about Cold War. I really am. And also hit that like button. It really helps out the channel. This feels so weird. I was playing this a little bit when I was grinding for phase 5. I thought, you know what, let's get some clips for it. Here comes the guy. But I was just using like the ballistic knife. I just wanna also note that I am an absolute Treyarch fanboy. I love every Treyarch game that's ever been made. Like honestly, like I said earlier, World at War is my favorite COD game of all time, like without a doubt. Like I can't, it might actually be my favorite video game of all time. Just looking back at all the memories I have on it, just playing as a little kid. Oh my God, this is a laggy game if I've ever seen one. I mean, me being biased is one thing, but I genuinely like, all right, let's say, whoa. Let's look at all the Treyarch games minus like everything before COD 4, all right? Back when Call of Duty actually like made a good run to like become the Call of Duty we know today, and everybody knows about it, right? So, World at War. And then you have Black Ops 1, which obviously I'm playing right now. This is either my second or third favorite game of all time in the COD franchise, at least. Modern Warfare 2 can take the other spot. I love that game so much. And then you have Black Ops 3. Black Ops 3, oh my God, how could I forget? I got to Master Prestige twice in that game. I was a huge fan of the advanced movement system, I really was. Black Ops 3 was might actually be a top 5 COD for me. And then we have Black Ops 4, which actually probably my least favorite of the Treyarch games, but on it, like, let's be real here. It got a lot of hate, and I really don't understand why. Like, I got to level 1000 on it. Like, that's a lot of playing. So I can't say, it's hard for me to talk trash on Black Ops 4. But the point is, I don't see Treyarch making a bad game, at least not for a long time. Why should this game be any different? I really need to get out of this lobby, but I don't think I'm gonna find much. I'm actually 15th prestige level 45, so I'm 5 levels away from hitting the max level, which I could honestly do today. So I'm not gonna really talk about anything in a particular order. I'm not gonna like sit here and talk about all the negatives and then talk about all the positives. I'm just gonna kinda bring things up as I think of them. I also have some notes written down here. Oh my God. How did I, holy crap! Dude, that was definitely the lag, because I killed that, I deleted him. I've been seeing a lot of people talking trash on the game, and once again, because I didn't actually get to play it, I really don't get much of a word in it, but I'm gonna say that a lot of people are just kinda baiting, but at the same time, there are obviously some issues. I saw a lot of bugs with the game, and obviously, I looked at the graphics, they don't look as good as, let's say, Modern Warfare, right? It looks like it is a bit of a step back, but I don't think that's much of a problem. I really don't think it's as much of a problem as people make it out to be. I still enjoy going back to games that are 10 plus years old, and I don't even consider the graphics, right? I just enjoy the game because it's a well-made game. Graphics, yeah, it's cool and all, like, yeah, next gen, PS5, the graphics are going to be incredible on these games, but it's not like everything to me. I'm more about story and how the game plays. Like Black Ops 1, for instance, I love how the game plays, and the graphics look like shit compared to everything else you see today. I do notice that the guns, for instance, they don't sound real. They sound like little arcade weapons, right? I was watching some stream and some guy basically described it as a decoy grenade. Like decoys in this game, if you remember what they sound like, they don't actually sound like guns. They sound like little guns that you would like hear in Toy Story, right? Like a Disney movie. Call of Duty, I think It's this arcade versus realism argument, right? And I think Call of Duty recently has been pushing to be more realistic. At least Modern Warfare really tried to be realistic. And yeah, it's fun, it makes it immersive, but when I look back at the older games, they're like clunky and they're weird. Like Black Ops 3, for instance, that game wasn't realistic at all, but it was so damn fun. This game's not realistic. And I think that's how COD's supposed to be. Look at this guy. Whoa! I was like, what the heck am I getting stuck on? I have my volume turned down super low because it's so loud. And I'm not gonna be like quick to judge a game until like I see the full version, especially after what happened with Black Ops 4. Oh my god. In Black Ops 4, for instance, you guys know if you watch my channel, I got to level 1000 in that game. It's just a ridiculous amount of time you have to put into a game to get to level 1000, right? And I hated the beta. I despised the beta in that game. Like, it actually like made me depressed. I'm like, oh my god, it's gonna be a bad year of COD. I'm like, what am I gonna do? Yeah, I just had so many things going through my mind. I just hated it. But when the game dropped, I fell in love with it, right? And obviously, like in the alpha and the beta, they're not gonna show you everything, and they're gonna make a lot of changes for the full game whenever it's released. Now, there are a lot of speculations still to be made about Cold War, like for instance, prestiging. As far as I'm aware, we're still not sure if they're putting prestiging into the game. And you know, the longer I think about it, the more I hear about it, the more I really don't think they're gonna do it, which it really irks me because the community is strongly pushing for it. It's like a vast majority of the players, they want prestiging back. I get from a business perspective why they don't want to do prestiging anymore and they wanna do seasons. It just makes more money, right? I just think it's a slippery slope. The more you like deviate from what the actual fans want, the harder it gets to keep them down the road. And whenever I think of prestiging, I think about how important it is. A lot of people, you know, they're like, it's prestiging, what does it matter? Like, it's just a prestige emblem. Me personally, one of the biggest things that has kept me playing Call of Duty as long as I have, one of the biggest things that has ruined my life because I put so many hours into it is prestiging, right? Despite all the issues that I had with Modern Warfare, I think I would have played it so much more if they had prestiging. It's just one of those things that keeps you coming back. It's just some weird psychological thing. I think it's a bad decision to take that away. Now, once again, we don't know for sure what they're doing, but I'm leaning towards them doing something similar to Modern Warfare. I do like a lot how they brought back Ninja as a perk. That is huge. That is one of the other main factors why I didn't want to play Modern Warfare. It was just sound whore heaven for a game that was designed for people to camp, right? Get out of here! Let's go! Like, Modern Warfare, Dude, I'm lagging up a storm, guys. I'm not trying to make excuses here, but this is laggy, man. This is really frustrating. And then you have the campaign. We haven't really seen much for it, but obviously that's back. Treyarch has made so many amazing campaigns, but except for Black Ops 3, we don't talk about Black Ops 3. We never will. And obviously Black Ops 4 did not have a campaign, which is disappointing, but Black Ops 1, Black Ops 2, World at War, those are like some of the best campaigns ever. Like, how can you hate on those? I saw this one video, it was just some clip from the campaign where you're with Woods and you drive this RC car and you crash this plane. It just looks so good. I think, once again, you know, people want to give the graphics hell. I don't think it makes that much of a difference, really. As long as the gameplay is good, I think it makes for a really fun experience. And in my opinion, Treyarch is really good when it comes to making maps. I think Modern Warfare really lacked in the map department. Like, I just keep thinking of Piccadilly, right? Piccadilly was so bad. It might actually be the worst map of all time. Euphrates Bridge, just like, I hated Modern Warfare. I thought it was a good game, but for someone like me, my playstyle, horrible game. All right, so I don't want people to get mad and say, it's a great game, because you know what, I agree. It just wasn't for me. Too many windows. Good nade, let's go. But from what I've seen, the maps look, they look good. They look good. I haven't played on them, but they look good. I actually heard that a lot of people really despise that Miami map. If you haven't seen it, it's like that 80s vibing, like vaporwave type map. I think it looks really cool, and I'm a big fan of the 80s, so maybe that's why I like it so much or wanna like it so much. It's that one map called Satellite, I think, where you're on this, no. Is that Armada? I think I kind of have the names down. It's when you're on the ship and you can drive around. There's like sharks in the water. It looks... What? Dude! Holy crap! And there's the other one. It reminds me of Afghan from Modern Warfare 2. I can't remember what it's called. That might be satellite. That... I can't do this. I can't do this. I can't do this. Did you see how that guy just skipped across my screen? I'm not playing that. I've also seen a lot of complaints that the game is really slow. Like, we're so used to what's called Super Sprint, right? So it's basically, it's one of these new things that have been implemented into the recent CODs, where basically you just infinitely sprint. Back in the day, like in this game, you'd sprint for like 5 meters and your character's winded and you have to walk, and it was just like more slow paced, right? It just wasn't as smooth. And going back and playing these games after playing the newer ones, it's kind of annoying. It's just one of those things you get used to. I think that type of gameplay doesn't exactly promote camping. You're gonna get campers regardless, no matter what. Like, you can't eliminate camping. It's still gonna be an issue. So I don't know why people are complaining so much about that. I do expect them to bring back a lot of old maps to the game like they did for Black Ops 4, which I'm totally fine with. I really am. I just don't like them making iterations of maps that are already in the game, like Hacienda, and making a Hacienda Twilight, or a Jungle Flooded when Jungle is perfectly fine, or Arsenal Sandstorm when Arsenal is a great map. We're gonna see a Nuketown. Nuketown is gonna come back. Like, there's no way they don't bring it back. It's just a staple. It's like the first thing you think of when you think of a Black Ops game, right? I would really like if they brought back Grid, though. This is one of the most slept on maps in history. I love this map so much. I'm not really sure about the specifics either, but Warzone is being continued, I guess? They're working with Infinity Ward to kind of just keep it going, which I think is great. I'm not much of a BR guy. You'll probably never see... Well, you'll probably see BR at some point on my channel, but it's like very infrequently, unless I really get into it, you know? I'm excited to see them continue that with like seasons, and I think it keeps everything super new and fresh and immersive. Another thing I want to talk about is the time to kill. I'm gonna put this up on the screen right now. I saw a screenshot on Twitter there was a guy behind me. Oh my god, I have rapid fire on this thing. I forgot. This guy just got destroyed. Okay. I can't see the numbers right now, but if you look at it, the time to kill in this game looks great. So Black Ops 4, the time to kill was a little too high. There's gonna be 150 health in this game, I believe, but that doesn't really matter if the time to kill is higher. You'll get kills quicker than in Black Ops 4, but slower than in Modern Warfare. I think Modern Warfare time to kill was way too fast. Oh, that's my boy. Okay, I don't know where they are. I'm just gonna call. There was another guy up there. Oh, I missed the napalm. I think that's coming back. There's a lot of old kill streaks that are coming back. I don't really understand the score streak system in this game. It's kind of like kill streaks, but not really. I saw a lot of people complaining, like, in Domination, pretty much at the start of every, like, the second round, like, at halftime. Everybody has score streaks just waiting, and they just spam them. So we'll just have to see. I don't think it'll be as bad as I thought it was gonna be. But pretty much the last thing I want to touch on is honestly the most important thing. It is the thing that has been making COD... I hate to sound this negative, but it's made COD more and more unenjoyable every year, and that's skill-based matchmaking. If you're not really sure what that is, basically, it's pretty much always been in the game, but not really. It used to pretty much be dependent on your rank, and as you know, like, you can be a Master Prestige or not be very good at the game. It's just how it is. But now, they've enforced it to the point where if you have a 2 KD, you're not gonna get lobbied up, or at least you're not gonna get teammates that are any good, but you're gonna get lobbied up against teams that have 2 KDs or higher very consistently. A lot of people might say, like, oh, what's the matter? You just want to stomp bad players all day and not face anyone at your skill level? It's not like that at all. But whenever you're doing that every single game and you just want to sit back, relax, and have a good time, even pros, like, they're in the same boat. It's just not fun. It ruins the experience. I don't want to make it a sweat fest. You guys know I like to go for camos on this channel. I like to make fun, at least videos that I think are fun and entertaining to watch. I don't want to use the best guns in the game and get 100 kill gameplays. Like, no, I just want to run around with a knife most of the time and just have a good time. It's so unenjoyable whenever everybody is playing like it's COD Champs. And, you know, it's just a video game, yeah, but it really gets to you after a while, especially when you've been playing for like hours. They need to do something about it, otherwise it's really just disappointing that they're not catering as much to the people that made the franchise as popular as it is. Because it is the good players that have been playing, generally. Like, the more you play, the better you're gonna be. And it's these players that have been playing for, like, over 10 years that can't win a game because the system is against them. And I know that feel. I'm not a great player, but I'm better than the average guy because I put so many hours into this game. And I know for a fact, in like half the games that I play, I'm set up to lose immediately. Like, there's just no chance. And it's very daunting, it's very frustrating, and it makes me wonder, like, will it ever end? So I don't know how long this video is gonna be. I feel like I've been talking for a long time. Those are my thoughts on the game. I don't think it's gonna be the best game we've ever had, but I think it's gonna be a lot better than people are giving it credit for. But what do I know? I am a Xbox player who doesn't get rights to play on the alpha or the beta. And in Modern Warfare, they put in some game mode or something that will not be available to anybody who doesn't play on PlayStation for the first year. You're telling me people paying the same amount of money are getting less just because they're playing on a different console? Or they're playing on PC? That's a joke and it's criminal. And yeah, Xbox had exclusive rights all those years ago. They would get the DLC like a week early or a couple days early. I don't remember. But that's the DLC, man. That's completely different. And games were not back then what they are now. So things have got to change, but I'm looking forward to the next game. I really am. But yeah, guys, I hope you all enjoyed this video. It's kind of a rant video, but I said previously I wanted to give my thoughts on the game before it came out, and I wanted to wait until the alpha was done. Another video will be dropping tomorrow, more gameplay stuff, and obviously more challenge videos coming up for all of you athlete freaks out there. Phase 5 is going to be announcing their top 100 in a couple weeks. I think the website said around October 5th, so give or take, it could be earlier. I'm nervous, guys, but I really am proud of the submission I put out, and I hope if you guys haven't seen it, I will put it down in the description if you want to check it out. Follow me on Twitter for more updates. I will also put that down in the description if you've made it this far. With that being said, I will catch you all in the next video. Let me know what your thoughts on Cold War are. Are you going to be getting it? Are you getting the new console? In times like these, we need to be more optimistic about things. I've been trying my best, so... Okay, see you guys later. Bye.